A very good morning to one and all, children. This is your English literature class and we are going to study a poem today. Before we start our poem, let us know something about the poet of the poem. She is the poet, children. You can see her picture on the screen. Her name is Christina Rossetti. Okay? So before we start the poem, I would like to tell you all about something about the poet. The name of our poet is Christina Georgina Rossetti. She was an English poet who wrote various, you know, romantic, devotional and children's poems. Goblin Market and Remember. These two were the most famous ones. These two poems were the most famous ones. In fact, children, these two poems are still very famous, which were written by Christina Georgina Rossetti. And this is how she looks. Okay, this is her picture in front of you. Now we are going to start with the poem, children. The name of our poem is The Rainbow. Okay, yes, it is The Rainbow. And I'm sure you all must have seen a rainbow before. It has how many colors in it? Seven. Children, it has seven colors in it. And we usually see a rainbow after good amount of rain. Okay, it is usually you see it in rainy season, or it does not depend upon the season, but it is basically after the rains. Okay, when we see a rainbow. Okay, these colors are there in a rainbow. How do we remember it? We remember it as vibgyor. Okay, we start from the color which is at the bottom. Okay, the bottom most: violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange and red. Okay, so these are the seven colors in rainbow, and the short form of it, you can remember it as vibgyor. Okay, now children, have you ever thought, I mean, how beautiful this creation is, isn't it? This rainbow, it is a creation by God, right? No man created it, children. It is a creation by God, and it is, you know, so pretty. I mean, so many colors, you can see it together at once. It makes me feel so good, and it makes me wonder, you know, how pretty things are, right? Okay, so what we are going to study today is the poem, children, The Rainbow. It is given in your book. Okay, so before we start reading this, I would like to tell you all, or you give you all a summary of the poem, that what the poem is all about. In this poem, children, The Rainbow, the poet Christina Rossetti, she depicts the beauty of a rainbow. As you can make out from the name itself, the name of the poem, that in this poem the poet is describing or telling us about the beauty of rainbow, about the beauty of nature. Okay, how beautiful the things are. The poet narrates that the boats that sail on the rivers and the ships that sail on the seas are doubtlessly pretty. Okay, but above them all, the clouds that sails across the sky are the prettiest. So basically, they are in this poem, children, the poet tells us, or the poet is, you can say, comparing the things which are made by God, the natural things, and the things which are made by man-made things. So the poet is comparing, and the poet is telling that the man-made things are also good, the man-made things are also pretty, but the things created by God, the natural things, are the prettiest. Okay, they are the prettiest, and she is comparing that. All right, okay, so I'm going to read the poem now. Let us all pay attention in the book, the page of the book. Boats sail on the rivers and ships sail on the seas, but clouds that sail across the sky are prettier far than these. Okay, children, this is the first stanza of this poem. The very first line: boats sail on the rivers. Okay, In this line, the poet is telling us that boats, they sail on the river, okay? That they move on the river. Boats move on the rivers. Ships, they move on the seas. You know, they sail on the seas. But clouds that sail across the sky, okay? There are clouds in the sky, and the poet is comparing, or you can say the poet is comparing clouds with boats and ships, and the sky with the rivers and seas. So the poet is telling that the way boats sail on the rivers, the ships sail on the seas, you know, that they move on the seas, they move on the rivers. Similarly, the clouds, they move across the sky from one end of the sky to the other end of the sky, and that looks far more prettier. Okay, it looks very, very pretty. Yes, children. So we studied this first stanza. I'm going to read it again for you all. Boats sail on the rivers and ships sail on the seas, but clouds that sail across the sky are prettier far than these. Okay, these means the ships and clouds, okay, the ships and boats are far prettier than the clouds. There are bridges on the rivers as pretty as you please, but the bow that bridges heaven over the tops of trees and builds a road from earth to sky is prettier far than these. Okay, so children, we are going to see the second stanza now. The very first line of it says, there are bridges on the rivers. Okay, children, you all know the meaning of bridge. Let me tell you all again. Bridge is something which connects two things, okay, like one end to the other end is connected by a bridge. So the poet Christina Rossetti is saying that there are bridges on top of the rivers, okay, as pretty as you please, and that looks very pretty also, okay. It looks very, very pretty, but the bow that bridges heaven. Bow means a knot tied with two loops and two loose ends are there, okay? So they are saying that the bridges which are there on top of the rivers, it looks very pretty. It is created by man and it looks very pretty. But the bridge which is there above, like in the heaven, over the top of trees and builds a road from earth to sky is far prettier than these. Children, in the second stanza, this third line, they are talking about the rainbow, okay? But the bow that bridges heaven, this bow here is the rainbow they are talking about, and they are telling, they are comparing, or you can say, a rainbow with a bridge, okay? So they are saying that this rainbow, okay, which connects the earth and the sky, and it goes from above the top of the trees, that is far more pretty, okay? That is more pretty in comparison to the bridges which are made by man and which are above the rivers, okay? In comparison to those bridges, this bridge, this rainbow, which is made by God, which is created by God, and it connects earth and sky, that is far more pretty than the bridge. Okay? So in this poem, children, the poet compared the natural things with man-made things. And she told us about the beauty of nature, okay? How pretty the nature is, all right? Okay. It also, this poet also tells us that people know they build beautiful bridges, but the rainbow, which is a bridge to the heaven, is however far more prettier than a man-made bridge. The rainbow here is compared to a bridge in the second stanza. From earth to the heaven, it connects. This bridge, this rainbow, connects earth and the heaven. And what is this poet teaching us? The moral of this poem is that nature's art of a rainbow is perhaps more beautiful than any other human creation. Okay, that the things created by God, the natural things, are more pretty, more beautiful than anything created by humans. Alright? Okay, so I'm going to read this whole poem once again for you all. Please pay attention to the pronunciation, children. Boats sail on the rivers and ships sail on the seas, but clouds that sail across the sky are prettier far than these. There are bridges on the rivers as pretty as you please, but the bow that bridges heaven over the tops of trees and builds a road from earth to sky is prettier far than these. Christina Rossetti. Alright, children, so we will see this again in our online class, the live class, and you all need to learn this poem. Alright, you all have to learn it and we will discuss this. Okay, and this is also a page from your book, children. This shows a scene of a park, maybe, okay, where the weather is so pleasant, the weather is so good, there is rainbow in the sky, clouds you can see birds, you know, and then people, they are enjoying themselves, they're having a very good time with their family. You can see a man standing along with his two children, then there is one man who's boating along with his child, right? So people, they all are having a good time when the nature shows its true colors, you know, it shows how pretty it is. Even people, even we as humans, we also have a very good time. We also enjoy, okay, being in that, in those natural things, right? Right. So children, there are some book exercises which we will be discussing in the class. All right. Till then, have a nice day, children. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you.